Welcome back, everybody. I said I was going to do this a really long time, not a really long time ago, but a while ago, and I never did. I kind of second-guessed myself, but now I am going to do it. But before I do, let me just preface this with a couple key things to keep in mind. First of all, when I said I was going to do this, some people were like, no, don't do rap music. You know, that's not the type of music you should be listening to and, you know, whatever. And I just want to remind you, you know, if you don't like a genre of music and you know that, you know, you're not going to like whatever I'm reacting to, just consider not clicking on the video. Second, more seriously, I'm not entirely sure how much of this song I've already heard. I know I've heard like part of it. It might have been part of like a censored version of it on the radio. Okay. But I'm excited to listen to it. I'm going out of my way to find the explicit version of it. So bear in mind, there's probably some explicit content. When I go through the lyrics, I'm probably not going to read everything out loud, but you can see what the words are. And yeah, this type of music is important, just like all the other types of music, you know? Contrary to what some people on my channel have said before, rap music is music. You know, there is music there. And also, I love lyrics. So I don't know a ton about rap in general, but I do love lyricism. And I don't know, I think I would like the genre a lot. Up to this point, the only rappers that I know all that much about would be like Eminem and Tupac. And that's about it. I might have heard one or two songs by other artists. I might be able to name a couple other artists, but those are the only two rappers that I've ever been able to be like, oh yeah, I like them. I know a couple songs by them. I know that my dad and my mom grew up listening to some types of rap music, as well as a ton of other types of music as well. And yeah, sorry if this is going on too long. I just wanted to preface this and say, you know, if you don't enjoy these types of this type of stuff, just don't watch. If you're new to the channel, welcome. I hope you enjoy these types of videos. I try to listen to music and figure out what it means, and just listen to great music. If you have any suggestions for rap artists or other songs by Tupac you'd like me to check out, leave them down below in the comments. Thank you very much for joining me. And yeah, I mean, the song samples, that's just the way it is, so I think it'll be great. Here we go. Tupac changes. It is explicit. Fair warning. Let's get into this. 3, 2, 1. I'm excited.
No changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a Negro. Pull a trigger, kill a nigga, he's a hero. Get it back to the kids, who the hell cares? One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship them, don't let them deal with brothers. Give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead. I got love for my brothers, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how I was supposed to be. How can the devil take a brother if he's close to me?
Wow.
I let it go back to when we played as kids, but then it changed. And that's the way it is. Come on, come on.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is.
Such a perfect thing to sample. Are you kidding me? Like, that's just the way it is a song that I reacted to, and that's where I said I would check out this song. And the song is like a commentary on like racism and other isms as well, but mostly racism. And yeah, it's interesting. I was recently learning about one specific thing that he talks about, like, give crack to the kids, who the hell cares, one less hungry mouth on welfare. Yeah. Yeah, they were, it's crazy that that the CIA like did that, like for that express reason. Yeah. We're going to go through all these lyrics. This might end up being a long video, but it's a good song so far. Let's keep going.
Oh, yeah.
Hear me.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's so good.
I see no changes. All I see is racist faces. Place hate makes disgrace to racist. We under, I wonder what it takes to make this one better place, let's erase the wasted. Take the evil out the people, they'll be acting right. Cause both black and white, and smoke a crack tonight. And the only time we chill is when we kill each other. It takes guilt to be real, time to heal each other. And although it seems heaven sent, we ain't ready to see a black president. It ain't a secret, don't conceal the fact. The penitentiary's packed, and it's filled with blacks. But some things will never change. Try to show another way, but you're staying in the dope game. Now tell me what's a mother to do. Being real don't appeal to the brother in you. You gotta operate the easy way.
I made a G today,
but you made it in a sleazy way. Selling crack to the kids.
I gotta get paid.
Well, hey, well, that's the way it is.
Wow, okay.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh, yeah. That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah.
We gotta make a change. It's time for us as a people to start making some changes. Let's change the way we eat. Let's change the way we live. And let's change the way we treat each other. You see, the old way wasn't working, so it's on us to do what we gotta do. And still I see no changes. Can a brother get a little peace? It's war on the streets and a war in the Middle East. Instead of war on poverty, they got a war on drugs so the police can bother me. And I ain't never did a crime, I ain't have to do. But now I'm back with the facts, giving it back to you. Don't let them jack you up, back you up, crack you up, and pimp smack you up. You gotta learn to hold your own. They get jealous when they see you with your mobile phone. But tell the cops I can't touch this. I don't trust this. When they try to rush, I bust this. That's the sound number two. You say it ain't cool, but mama didn't raise no fool. And as long as I stay black, I got a stage strap. And I never get to lay back, cause I always got to worry about the payback. Some buck that I roughed up way back, coming back after all these years. Right, tap, 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 tap.
That's the way it is.
That's just the way it is.
Okay, let's finish the song before I start talking. Here we go.
Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah.
You're my brother, you're my sister.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh, yeah.
Something will never change.
Wow. So here's the thing. There are aspects of this song that I will probably never completely understand. But songs like this help me understand at least a little bit, you know? And it's just interesting. You know, I the first few years of my life, I lived in Florida, okay? And there was never, as far as I saw, I never saw any type of, there's no other word for it. I never saw, like, racist, I never saw any type of racism, you know? You'd still hear about it, but I never saw it in anything. Then we moved to Georgia, and there have been a few situations where I have seen like explicit racism, and it's disgusting, and it's just interesting. I'm hopefully that we're moving in the right direction, but what do I know? You know, I can only work on my, I can only make sure that I am always in the right mindset, you know? It's difficult to talk about this because with the way things are right now, I feel like I shouldn't even be talking about it in the first place, but this entire song's about it, so I kind of have to. Yeah, because, you know, I'm on Twitter, and there'll be people on Twitter who don't even want, who will say, like, a white person's opinion on stuff like this doesn't even matter in the first place, or, like, who would get mad if at what I'm saying right now, probably. So I don't know. I hope I don't overstep my bounds in any ways by listening to this music, but I don't think I am. So yeah, let's take a look at all these lyrics and see all of the... He's like exposing a lot here. So let's go through it. Changes is Pac's timely meditation on race, class, and politics. Another thing about rap music, it'll probably often force... conversations about politics, so be aware of that if you watch my videos where I talk about rap music. The piano and chorus are sampled from The Way It Is by Bruce Hornsby and The Range. So, first verse. I see no changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor, and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. You can read the... I can't say some of these things, but as a rapper, he speaks for the whole community, which allows him to embody an ordinary black man living in the suburbs. He wonders about the meaning of life, and he's seeing that there's no changes going on. There's constantly people talking about the change that needs to happen, but there's no changes actually taking place. He's still in the same screwed up situation. Unfortunately, these morning thoughts seemed not to be too far from real life for people in the same situation. And also, the lyrics try to capture the desperation of poverty. He's rapping about the reality that low-income communities face in America. Crime isn't like an elective pastime. For some, it's a means of survival. Therein lies the cyclical oppression. Let me look up that word real quick. Occurring in cycles, okay. So the cycle of oppression, wow. He experienced poverty growing up and wanted to represent life as it was for a lot of poor people growing up in an unjust racist society. He says, every day I'm standing outside trying to sing my way in. We are hungry, please let us in. We're hungry, please let us in. After about a week, that song is going to change too. We are hungry, we need some food. After 2 or 3 weeks, it's like, give me the food or I'm breaking down the door. After a year, it's just like, I'm picking the lock, coming through the door. So this line is relatively straightforward, you know. Cops don't care. And they're, you know, he's saying that the cops that he's seen and experienced are racist POSs who pull the trigger, kill someone. He's a hero now. So you might read this line and think he's being melodramatic, but remember that the LAPD are some corrupt thug MFers. A reference to the institutionalized racism in America and how if a police shoots... And remember the time when this song came out as well, you know? So if a police shot a black man, he's more likely to be considered a hero instead of a criminal. Pac was politicized in the era of the Rodney King beating and the subsequent LA riots. The line is very relevant years later today when you look at the repeated murders by police officers, his lyrics still ring true today. there's a lot of heavy subject matter going on here. All right, give crack to the kids. Who the hell cares? One less hungry mouth on welfare. The crack epidemic of the 80s and 90s was considerably worse in predominantly black neighborhoods, but that was ignored because of the perceptions that they were burdening the tax system with excessive dependence on welfare payments from the government. It has been alleged several times that the CIA itself was involved in indiscriminate distribution of cocaine and herb in America to both kids and adults alike to further their own selfish ends. It's not even alleged anymore. It's like, there are so many things to back up that claim. Yeah, it's interesting. I've done some research on that specific thing recently. First, ship them dope, let them deal it to each other. Give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other. A reference to the Iran-Contra affair, in which many believe that it led to the government intentionally distributing harmful drugs. It's time to fight back. That's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark. Now Huey's dead. Huey P. Newton, the founder of the Black Panthers, was shot dead by a drug dealer in Oakland at the age of 47. Reports say there were three shots. Tupac's parents were active members of the Black Panther Party. Also refers to the FBI's history of targeting and monitoring black and other supposed revolutionary figureheads and implementing strategies to eliminate them by smearing their public image or worse, by assassinating them. You only have to look at their sister organization, the CIA, who have repeatedly instigated coups and assassinations of international leaders. I've got love for my brother. It could be referring to his African-American brothers, but from the tone of the song, it is more likely that he's referring to fellow humans in general, and that progress can't be made if we don't learn to accept and appreciate each other's differences. That's what I got out of the song when I heard like the very end of it, and he's like, we need to make some changes, we need to change the way that we're living, change the way that we see each other and treat each other and learn to respect each other, you know, and I'm like, yeah, it's like bringing it all together, you know? It's trying to move forward in the best way possible. He's could also be talking about Huey in this line. We can never go anywhere unless we share with one another. Similar to when Abraham Lincoln said, a house divided against itself cannot stand. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how it's supposed to be. How can the devil take someone if he's close to me? If we begin to show care to members of our communities and become more tolerant of different types of people, then it will be hard for people to slip between the cracks, as members of the community will be watching out and caring for each other instead of callously turning a blind eye, you know? That's the biggest problem. Good people who don't do anything. Jeez, yes, a shift in how we view each other really could improve life for everyone. The devil may refer to crooked, corrupt people who have often been termed white devils by black empowerment groups like the Nation of Islam and Black Panther Party. If this was to happen where everyone treats everyone like siblings, the world would be a better place and there would be, you know, peace. Devil could refer to sin and evil in general. Tupac could be saying that if we all stay close together, sin and moral evil can't separate us. I'd love to go back to when we played as kids. That's an allegory I've heard before that I always appreciated, you know, when people talk about, you know, racism and how ridiculous it is. And they're like, you know, if you just took two kids, you know, and they have different skin tones and put them together and they would just, you know, hang out, be friends, probably, you know. Love to go back to when we played as kids, but things change. That's the way it is. The way it is refers to the sample the song uses. Bruce Hornsby in the Range is the Way It Is, which is also about racial intolerance. Hornsby reported that he was honored by Tupac's use of the melody. Two ways to look at this couplet. Literally, the places and conditions that existed when he was a kid have changed, and he can never revisit them because everything is different. B, growing up has changed his outlook on life, and he can no longer recapture the same energy and happiness he had felt as a kid. When you're a child, you don't automatically see differences. First, you see potential to make a new friend. Skin color doesn't inherently matter. Racism is taught, not bred. And that's, there you go, that's the mic drop. This might also remind the listener of the movie Juice, which Tupac played in, where at the end of the movie, after Bishop dies, it flashes back to the scene where the whole crew's together, likely Q remembering how things used to be and wishing they could still be that way, but obviously they can't. Okay. We're not even that far through the song. All right, then we've got the chorus. The chorus is a reworking of the chorus from The Way It Is. Oddly, the new line, "Things will never be the same," seems to suggest that change has come. And change is coming. So then we have verse 2. A significant portion of this verse was originally released as a part of "I Wonder If Heaven's Got a Ghetto." Okay, interesting. "I see no changes. All I see is racist faces. Misplaced hate makes disgrace to races. I wonder what it takes to make this one better place. Let's erase the wasted. Take the evil out the people. They be acting right. Because both black and white are smoking crack tonight. And the only time we chill is when we kill each other. It takes skill to be real and time to heal each other." A very powerful group of lines right there. So he thinks that hate is misplaced. People's hate placed on, you know, races and stuff, when people should be placing their hate on evil things in the world. There is disgrace to races because hating on other humans based on race is disgraceful to anyone that does it. And I completely, wholeheartedly, and totally agree with that. And like, something that woke me up a little bit to that aspect of the world, I guess, is the generational wars that you see on the internet. When you see these like big newspapers and productions, right, who reference things like Gen Z, millennials, and boomers and stuff like that. And it's like creating new groups for people to want to, it's creating more division for people to fight over. And constantly dividing people keeps them fighting with each other, as opposed to looking for the root of the actual problems with society. So the longer we're distracted by trite nonsense that's, you know, being turned into these huge issues, such as like the color of your skin shouldn't matter at all, you know, like that. Racism was like originally used as a justification for these people who wanted to believe that slaveholding was moral. Bunch of Christian people who wanted to pretend like what they were doing was okay. And then it was taught, until now there's like no real meaning behind it other than hate. Misplaced hate. When instead that type of anger and aggression should be being turned toward the people who are dividing in the first place. Let's continue. Sorry for the rant. All right. Take the evil out of people, they'll be acting right. There are two sides in a person, a good side and a dark side. Take the dark, evil side out of the person, they will be acting right in society. The line below it should be taken together. This line should be taken with the line below it. He's saying that the evil that people suffer could be drugs, specifically cocaine. And remember, this song is like, it said a timely piece, right? This song is made with a ton of historical and cultural background of the time it came out. Now there are some different problems. A lot of the problems have stayed the same. Some of them have changed a little bit, you know? So keep that in mind while listening to these, you know, definitions that like, specifically like that all evil people suffer would be cocaine. So it has devastated urban communities and is a primary cause for inner city violence across the country. However, contrary to popular belief, it is not specifically a black problem. In reality, poor white communities have also suffered from proliferation of drug use. He's encouraging his listeners to get the drug trade out of our communities, white and black, because they bring out the worst in people regardless of race. People of all races commit crimes, however, institutionalized racism encourages society to label people of color as criminals. This doesn't just refer to smoking crack. However, Pac uses the reference here to emphasize that one of the labels was like calling people, you know, drug lord or drug dealers. Jeez Louise. There's so much, and that's another thing about rap music is lyrically, a lot of times, very, very, very dense. Some, I've heard a couple rap songs that are very, like, that are shallow or have no real meaning behind it, or are just, like, about sex or something, and they're just super, like, explicit. But stuff like this has a lot of, has a lot of emotion behind it. All right, so the only time the two races get some bonding time is when they're killing each other. He's like pointing out almost sarcastically this problem, this divide. It takes skill to be real and time to heal each other. So it takes skill to look and understand things the way they are and talk about them for real, you know, just like what we're doing right now, you know. You know, leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts, you know. Take skill to be real and time to heal each other. There you go. Man, that should be everyone's, like, motto. Not everyone's motto, but I really like that line. All right. Although it seems heaven sent, we aren't ready to see a black president. Wow. We have now. Recorded in 92, he thinks a black president would end up being more divisive for the country, and it would be best to wait for more tolerant times. 2008. Yeah. He was mostly right. Were we really all ready for Obama in 2008? No, not at all. As soon as the results were announced, outcry ensued all over the United States, primarily in the South. Many ignorantly believed he was being elected just because he was black. No one was really ready for a black president, and evidence can be found in the media or even right outside your door. It's crazy. It's interesting. I was recently watching some things with Obama in them, like some of his, like, the way that he handled, like, hecklers in the crowd and how he talked to them. And I was like, you know, maybe I don't agree with everything that he stood for, but he was an extremely, I can definitely see why he got elected, you know. He was very good at what he did. All right, moving along, let's see. It isn't a secret, don't conceal the fact. The prison system is packed and it's filled with black people. The U.S. have reported to have one of the biggest prison... The U.S. is reported to have one of the largest prison populations in the world. Moreover, as the federal justice system and the police pay more attention to black people, they are way more numerous than any other ethnic group, and it doesn't change over the recent years. To him, it's another large injustice that nobody seems to care about, and that is sadly still existing with the publication of the book The New Jim Crow in 2010. Some things will never change. Try to show another way, but you're staying in the dope game. Now tell me, what is a mother supposed to do? Being real doesn't appeal to the brother in you. You've got to operate the easy way. I made a G today, but you made it in a sleazy way, selling crack to kids. I've got to get paid. Well, that's the way it is. Being real is a term that means actually working hard towards what you want and not taking shortcuts. He's saying that even though they want to work a normal job and have a good life, the brother in them, meaning gangster and the like, doesn't want to. Let's see. On one hand, being real, hard work, low pay implies agreeing with your mother. On the other hand, selling crack, easy, big money, popular with the ladies. He's trying to bring to the dealer's attention that they are profiting out of kids who are hooked on the drugs. And as we all know, drugs are destructive to people's lives. He doesn't agree with him, but he understands that this life is turning into a game and we all need to make money for obvious reasons. Yes. Another one, kind of like Janie's Got a Gun, where I can't really... I don't want my sister to be standing right up there listening to everything that I'm saying here. Okay, I believe that, and this is the comment, I believe Pac's bringing up a morality issue here, and this is an example of how some people don't care about others as long as they make money, but that's the way it is, but it must be changed. The definition of status quo is the way it is. Wow, all right. That's powerful. And then just a repeat of the chorus, then we've got an interlude. We've got to make a change. It's time for us as a people to start making changes, change the way we eat, change the way we live. Several hip-hop musicians focus on the importance of healthy diet and lifestyle above and beyond just not taking drugs as important part of empowerment. As an important part of empowerment. All right. Let's change the way we treat each other. You see, the old way isn't working. So it's on us to do what must be done to change everything and survive. I see no changes. Can't we get a little peace? There's war on the streets, war in the Middle East. Instead of war on poverty, they've got a war on drugs. He wrote Changes in 92, about a year after the United States ended a war in the Middle East, Operation Desert Storm, aka the Gulf War, which involved Iraq and Kuwait. Hopefully I pronounced that correctly. I might have not done that. The song was released in 1998, on October 13th. Not even 2 months after its release, Operation Infinite Reach was implemented. Since then, there has still been war on the streets, both in the U.S. and in the Middle East. He's also making a comparison between the harshness going on in the Middle East and the BS on the streets. He's referring to how America is paying more attention to wars in foreign countries than the corruption that's actually in America during the 90s. Instead of a war on poverty, they've got a war on drugs. The war on poverty was the unofficial name for legislation first introduced by Lyndon Johnson in 64. The national poverty rate was at about 19% at the time. His speech, which discusses the issues of race, led the United States Congress to pass the Economic Opportunity Act, which established an office, the OEO, to administer the local application of federal funds targeted against poverty. 7 years later, when Nixon was in office, he coined the term war on drugs. Other people, Ronald Reagan, George H.W. Bush, along with other people in the government, pushed for more involvement in this. Overall, it reciprocates what Johnson was doing as it discontinued helping the poor and started helping people who benefit most from drugs, the bankers who launder the money in the first place. Most people do not resort to crimes because of need, not because they want to. Would a person ever steal food if he had plenty in his house? In Dear Mama, Tupac says, I ain't guilty, because even if I sell rocks, it feels good putting money in your mailbox. Can he really be blamed for committing crimes when he's clearly struggling to survive? Well, I don't know. All right. But now I'm back with facts and giving it back to you. Don't let them. So then he says, don't let them jack you up, back you up, crack you up, and pimp smack you up. You've got to learn to hold your own. They get jealous. So he's talking directly to, you know, he's talking to these communities that are being, that are under attack, basically. And he's being as real with them as he possibly can. And he's saying, here's the facts, you know, don't let them do this. Here's why they're doing it. They get jealous when they see you with your mobile phone. Yeah, wow. My mom didn't raise no fool. Coming back after all these years, rat-a-tat-tat-tat, that's still the way it is. Yep. Some things will never change. And there we go. That's what we've got there. Changes by Tupac. Yeah. Let's take a look at some of the comments. Crazy how relevant this song is almost 25 years later. Yeah. This person says, I don't want to live in a world where Gucci Gang has 1 billion views and this masterpiece only has 9 million. Is that true? That is, that's not good. That is very bad. Wow. Okay. This person says, don't be sad he's gone. Be happy he was here. I'm still sad he's gone, actually. But, you know. They say he wrote this at 19. The guy's a legend. It's kind of weird to actually miss someone you never knew. That's true. But still sad. You know. All right. Thank you for joining me. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. And again, I learned a lot today, you know, just from reading all that. And I learned a lot of things. So, again, let me know what else I should check out down below in the comments. And I will see you guys soon. Deathstroke 9, out. We are Legion, my friend.